DeepSeek R1 is the buzzword of the last 2 days, and it makes sense. They just match GPT-4 reasoning capabilities, but making it completely open, actually showing the reasoning thread or chain of thought and returning it in the API. That made Nvidia lose nearly $600 billion of its market cap and is causing a big disruption in the AI market. But despite the AI ecosystem movement, at Appsmith we want to enable enterprises to build low-code AI apps integrating with multiple platforms, and DeepSeek R1 is not the exception. Two open source platforms, one private AI powerhouse, build internal apps with AI reasoning in minutes, host them anywhere, on your data, completely private. Let's see how easy it is to do it.
So the easiest way to integrate DeepSeek with Appsmith is to run it on the cloud. You could self-host it very easily on your own machine and integrate it internally with your own Docker image of Appsmith or in your own private servers. But for this demonstration, I'm just going to run it in the cloud. Together.ai is a platform that right now provides DeepSeek R1, so you can integrate it with their API very easily. But again, you can try Vertex AI Model Garden. You can run it on your own private server. At the end, the procedure is going to be the same, but for the sake of testing, this is the easiest way. Once you create your account on together.ai, which gives you free credit to test it out, which is great, you will see underneath here your balance, which is $1, good enough to try it out. They will provide an API key that you will need to use for the integration, and also they will provide some data samples for you to use it. So you will see that there's a lot of popular models here you can run, and we will find DeepSeek R1 over there. If you go to their playground for the DeepSeek R1, you will see that they have their Python library, their TypeScript, and then the curl request. That's the one we're going to be using. So let's copy this curl request and go to the Appsmith app. In Appsmith, let's create a new application or open your existing application you want to integrate. And there you will see the queries section. In the queries, you will create a new query, and there you will find the new curl import. Click over there and then paste the content we copy. There you will see that there is this together API key variable that we have to replace. So let's delete that. Let's go back to together. Let's find our API key, copy it, go back to Appsmith and paste it over there. Now, the other thing you will notice is that in the messages array, there's no message. So right now, if we try this out, nothing is going to happen because we didn't send or provide any message to DeepSeek. So it's very easy to do that. All we have to do is put an object as an user with a message. So let's just add that object here. I'm just going to add, let me do this correctly here. There you go. In the array, one object, role, user, and just the content that I'm asking, which is what a DeepSeek. Let's click import. And over there, what's going to happen is that Appsmith is going to create or pre-populate an API request for us. There you will see your authorization barrier. Also, you will find the body request and the authentication section. Now, the only thing I will recommend for the sake of testing, since everybody is trying right now DeepSeek with this platform, the request might time out. So let's just increase the timeout to 1600 milliseconds just to make sure that the API request is going to work correctly. But again, if you self-host DeepSeek or you run it on your own server, that shouldn't be the problem. So let's run it and we should see a response over here. And there you go. Now we have a response and we can take a look at the data structure of the response. We can see that we have the different meta information here, and then you will find here the choices, which is an array. And then on each object inside that array, there will be an index and a message with the response from the assistant. And there you will have the content of the response that we just asked over here. So this is great. The only thing that's not so good is that we're sending the barrier token as a completely plain text, and obviously this is bad from a security standpoint, but we can save this as a data source, structure the authorization token as something that Appsmith stores privately, and we can securely use this for multiple purposes. So let's click on this button that says save URL, and this will create a data source for us. It's gonna call it DeepSeek. Everything else will be fine, but let's remove the authorization barrier token here from the header and scroll down where it says authentication type, select the barrier token. And like I said, Appsmith is going to store this barrier token as an encrypted value that no one can retrieve again. So let's save that. And now this has been replaced by Appsmith in our requests. Finally, let's give it a name. We can maybe rename this to DeepSeek. There you go. Now we should be ready to go back to the UI and build it. Let's click in the UI tab, and here let's bring a text element just that we can see the response from the API request. Let's bring a paragraph here, and let's do here DeepSeek.data. Remember, we saw the choices array. For now, we're just going to show the first element in that array, find the message property, and then I think that should be it. Now, the content property. And there you go. This is the response that we got from the API request from DeepSeek. Now, the last thing we have to do is build the actual integration with an input, and you can have a conversation with it. So let's do that. Let's find a input value here. Let's put it on the top in the same zone. And what we can do right here is just call this message. And let's bring a button here. Maybe we can put it next to the label. And this button is going to say talk. Well, it's going to say send. That's easier. And now all we have to do is bind an onClick event to this particular button here. It's going to execute a query, DeepSeek. And now let's go back to the DeepSeek body here, request, and let's replace this content with data interpolation. So in this case, we're going to find the name of the input that we created here. It was message. So let's go back to the query, find message.text, and that should be it. So if we try out this app, let's see what is the best season to go to New York, and click send. My browser just changed to dark mode in the best moment. There you go, because we just got the answer from DeepSeek. And what is very interesting about it is that first you will see the thinking or the reasoning behind the answer that it provided us. So you will see that inside this think tag that we can see over here. So it's telling us, okay, I need to figure out the best season to visit New York. Let me start by thinking about the different seasons and what they offer. New York is very distant. We have summer, spring, fall, and winter. And then it's going to talk about summer, the fall, the winter. So the best season is probably depends on the person's prefers. If they want a mild weather, a fewer crowds, maybe a spring or the fall. So here's sort of the reasoning inside this think tag that DeepSeek is doing to provide us an answer. And then we have the actual answer. So he's saying that the best time to visit New York depends on your preference of weather, crowds, and activities. And here's a seasonal breakdown to help you decide. And it's breaking down fall, spring, winter, and I think it stopped. Probably we might have run out of tokens for the $1 credit that we got out of the Together AI. But the integration is like this. Very simple. Just do the data source of the curl. You're going to get the API token, and then you can start integrating your apps with applications with DeepSeek with no problem whatsoever, independently if it's running locally on your private server or using any cloud service that is going to provide you with the DeepSeek model. Start building with DeepSeek right now, and let us know in the comments what do you think.